Hey, killer.
What?
Hey, it's cool. Your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
Haven't you been watching the news?
Once again, our top story tonight, Malcolm Corley, owner of Corley Motors, was found dead at a rest stop just outside the town of Melonweed. Apparently, the benevolent patriarch and CEO was viciously beaten about the head and neck, savagely and without mercy. Police have arrested a notorious outlaw biker gang known as the Polecats.
No.
With the exception of their leader, who is still at large. Roadblocks have been set up along Highway 9 in an effort to apprehend this dangerous and violent criminal.
We've been set up. Roadblocks suck. I shouldn't have left the gang there.
Hey, I don't want to hear anything about it. You ain't making me an accessory after the fact. Just lay low, man.
I can do that.
Not gonna happen.
Let me show you how to do that.
Not gonna happen.
Let me show you how to do that.
Not gonna happen.
Seem to have a lot of time on your hands. Not to mention nicks and scratches. Am I distracting you? That's your truck out front. I need a ride.
I look like a cabbie to you. Get lost. They're not letting anyone through that roadblock anyway.
Not even truckers?
They turned me around, said police business only. Pigs.
Look, I really need a ride.
Not gonna happen.
Why? Because you're afraid of some cops?
No, because I don't like you.
I just killed a guy.
I'm just about to.
I don't think that's good for the table.
Hey, Quahog.
Yeah, Emmett?
I'm gonna be knifing up your table for a while, all right?
The customer with the knife is always right.
Good talking to you. Friendly folks you get in here.
Emmett's not what you'd call an I'm okay, you're okay person.
Ah, shut your hole, Quahog.
Look, let me tell you what happened.
I told you, I don't want to get involved.
Psst. Ben, no time to talk.
You know, it stank in there, but I can't remember a better sleep.
You gotta help me. Go find my editor in Corville. Tell him I took pictures of the Corley murder.
You got pictures?
Yeah, but some thug took my camera.
So you don't have any pictures?
Well, I tracked the guy to Melonweed, but I'm not going near the place. They'd kill me. Get my editor. He's gotta get me out of this. Take one of these fake IDs to get through the roadblocks. My career is riding on those pictures. Help me, Ben. You're my only hope.
Oh, don't worry. I owe you one. I've touched it enough. Take that.
Quit it!
And that.
Quit it!
And that.
Quit it!
Here.
What's that?
Fake federal investigator ID. Could be of some use at one of those roadblocks. Ever hear of this place? Uncle Pete's Mink Ranch?
I remember there used to be some sort of weasel plantation or something up the road.
Down Highway 9 on the other side of them damn roadblocks. I used to pick up mink meat there real cheap and sell it to school lunch programs. That was a good scam.
So how about a ride? What if they search the back and find my bike?
It's buried in a pile of concentrated fertilizer powder. Trust me, no one's gonna dig through that crap. Now you're gonna ride in the engine compartment.
The engine compartment?
Hey, I smuggle stuff in there all the time, and most of it's worth more than you. So stuff your carcass in there quick, and we might hit that mink dump by morning.
Hope you're better with a stick shift than you are with a knife.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, great. Smells like he's got a fuel leak. I love engine fires.
Sorry, sir. Only police vehicles beyond this point.
I'm with the feds, Chump. Check it out.
Huh? What's this about?
Undercover agricultural sting operation.
What's in the back?
Fertilizer.
All right, move along.
Hope you rubes get your man.
Problem with your truck?
Loose hose, nothing big. I already pulled your bike out. It's sitting right over there. Well, nice knowing you. Gotta hit the road, you know.
Uh-oh. He did have a fuel leak, and he took my fuel line to fix it. That trucker's gonna die for what he did. I don't walk. I don't have anything. Junk. And a hose I can use on my bike. I don't think Mo would mind if I borrow him. Mo? Booster fuel. Why is she running from me? She must think the whole world's against her. I think I know how that feels. That does it. He's dead. That sign. That means I'm in cavefish territory.
This cargo is worthless. We have been tricked, my brothers. Back to the cave.
The place looks deserted. Maybe the boss was wrong and she ain't coming here.
She's coming. We just got here first. That means all we have to do is sit here and wait.
That's all of them. Can't be much holding that up now. What a mess. Maybe I'll just take a little. I'm not putting my lips on that. Tightrope walkers, hang gliders, human cannonballs. Many have tried to cross the mighty Cuyahoga Gorge, and many have failed. Except for Ricky Myron, the Flying Torch, who jumped the gorge on a stock Corley motorcycle. It was later uncovered that he had modified his Corley with a pre-regulation destroyer-class solid-fuel recoil booster and an automotive hover lift. Myron said he would gladly replicate the jump to clear his name, but his special ramp was stolen by a mysterious truck hijacking motorcycle gang. Recoil booster and a hover lift, eh? Thanks for the tip, Rick. You're right, though. I'll need that ramp.
Look at him run.
Thank you.
It was Nesta's fault.
Get in quick. I have a plan. We're going to lure the Corley women out of hiding with a bike.
Boss, she already has a bike.
Yes, but this one she worked on with her father. It's an emotional thing. Don't try to understand. Now hurry.
Looks okay for an aftermarket part. Father Torp. I haven't seen you since you retired from the Polecats.
Hey, Ben. How's my gang doing?
That's a long story. What are you doing out here?
Well, retirement's pretty boring, Ben. So I thought I'd come out to the old mine road and look for trouble.
You're picking fights?
That's what the old mine road's for, son.
Father Torque, I need your help. The gang's in jail and the law.
Ben, I'm not the leader of the Polecats anymore. You are. Can't you see I'm on permanent vacation?
Any fighting tips, Torque?
Ben, who's tougher than you?
Nobody, but those rod wheelers are uglier.
They're none too bright, either. I'm sure you can handle them.
The vultures are quick, and they're nuts.
The ones with those boosters are hard to whip. Just remember, Ben, it's not about muscle, it's about timing.
What's up with those cavefish, man?
Watch out, Ben. They're not out here for sport. They hijack big rigs. It's part of their religion. Don't get in their way. They're blind, cold-hearted killers.
How do the cavefish ride if they're blind?
Well, they're only blind because they wear those special goggles to shield their sensitive cave-dwelling eyes. Special sensors in the goggles pick up the dots in the road and other large objects and landmarks to help them navigate. Kinda trippy, huh?
You know any way around Cuyahoga Gorge?
Around it? It's miles and miles long, Ben. What's the matter? Don't like bridges?
It blew up.
Ooh, sorry I missed that. Well, you could jump it, like Ricky Myron. Cavefish got its ramp in their hideout, you know.
Where is the cavefish hideout exactly?
Somewhere on this road. The entrance is totally invisible unless you got those weird cavefish specs. Can't talk anymore, Ben. Eating too many bugs.
Well, take it easy, Father.
Give him hell, Polecat.
You like choppers, huh? How about this chopper? Oh!
Say there, is that a pre-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster you have there?
Why, yes it is. Ta-ta!
You crowd me, shovel face. Anchor or something?
That should have a couple of good boosts left in it.
Thank you.
I'm done with these boys. Enough.
Souvenirs here. We got your hats. We got your... What can I get you?
Why all the lights down here?
We got a demolition derby tonight. First prize is a vintage curly hardtail, completely restored by the old man himself. Yep.
What's this big arena doing way out here?
Corley built the smashatorium so his employees could have some wholesome entertainment nearby. He sure took care of his employees. I got no idea what's gonna happen to us now that he's gone.
I'm looking for a good souvenir.
Well, good souvenirs is all I got. What can I fix you up with?
Something small, furry, and yellow.
Sorry, this is the only set of teeth I got. Dang, there goes another one.
How about that little car there?
It's small, but it's not cheap, my friend. You better just take it for a test drive to make sure.
Those shirts come in extra, extra large?
No, but they're pre-shrunk.
No thanks. What do those pennants say on them?
Can't beat a Corley, they say. Kind of ironic, actually, considering how he died. Still, look great on your bedroom wall.
No walls. My bike is my home.
We could set you up with a little pole so you could make a flag, you know, for your back seat.
Think about it. Bunnies, and plenty of them.
You want bunnies? I got your bunnies. How much you got on you?
Can I just take them out for a test drive?
I think you may not be ready for the kind of commitment that comes with a Corley Bunny Value Pack. Sorry, son. Do you actually have any money?
As much as I need. What's in the hat?
I don't know. Came filled with it. Probably some sort of packing material. Packs a punch, I'll tell you that much.
Seen any vultures around here?
Nah, we don't have much of a vulture problem here, even though their hideout is right up the road. They stay pretty much locked up in there. Not very social. Looky here. Nothing personal, but why don't you mosey along and stop scaring away all the other customers, all right?
Just clearing my throat.
We got it all right here. Sure, sure. Take it for a spin. Just don't go out of range. Official Corley Motors merchandise.
Looks like it's getting weak.
Oh, great. You killed the batteries. Drive your own derby car by remote control.
Excuse me, but are those shirts, are they all cotton?
Well, let's just see here. 100% cotton.
Oh. That's too bad. I'm allergic to cotton.
Lovable, lovable little bunnies.
I don't walk. There's the vulture's hideout on the other side of this field. I've heard a lot about the vultures. And I guess it's all true. Those weapons were out of weight.
We got your t-shirts here.
That should put some life into it.
Sure, sure. Take it for a spin. Just don't go out of range. All sizes and colors. Hey, don't go in there. Now look what you did. The entrance is all the way through the factory. Hang on, little buddy. Daddy's coming.
Now it's just me and the bunnies. No mementos. I'll have scars enough to remind me of this trip. Field's been replanted. Tidy little vote. I hate surprises. Thank you.
That's the guy I was telling you about, Susie.
You sure?
Yeah, that's the guy who killed my father.
All right, vultures, rack them up!
Let's rip them quick.
Listen, Mo, you're making a big mistake.
Oh, Ben, you're right. We shouldn't do this quickly. We should draw this out, don't you think, Susie?
Hey, I got all night. You heard her, kids. Let's draw this out.
Your father.
Don't you dare talk about my father, you heartless bastard.
Let me go, or else...
Or else what?
I'll call you names.
Like what?
Diaper Dynamo.
How? How'd you hear that name?
Your father. He told me just before he died.
You bludgeoned my father and then talked about old times?
I didn't kill him. Ripberger did. A photographer took pictures, but her camera was stolen by the same thug that came after you.
I still have that role.
Well, develop it, would you? While I still fit in my clothes?
Okay, you stay here.
Hey.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, don't sweat it.
I'm gonna get Ripberger even if I die trying.
No. We have to expose Ripberger at the shareholders' meeting. That way, we take him down, we save my gang, and your father gets his dying wish. You take over Corley Motors.
Ripberger canceled the shareholders' meeting. He made a statement to the press that there'd be no meeting until the murderers were brought to justice.
So, no shareholders' meeting until we're both dead?
That could be arranged.
Okay, so here we go. Faking Ben and Maureen's death. Act 1, Scene 1. Adrian Ripberger, in a desperate attempt to lure our Maureen out of hiding, has developed the following lame-ass scheme. First prize at tonight's smash-up derby is a vintage hardtail that Mo restored with her dad. Rip hopes Mo will try to nab said bike on account of her sentimental attachment to it. So Ben and Mo play along, put on disguises, and enter the demolition derby, which ends tragically when their cars explode and both are presumed dead.
Question.
Please save your questions until the end. Now, the explosives in Mo's car can only be triggered by a head-on collision with Ben's car. This ejector seat projects Mo clear of the explosion, and she parachutes to safety.
Don't you think someone will notice her ejecting out of her car?
No. They'll all be watching you running around on fire.
Yeah, that's another question I have.
When your car explodes, you climb from it in flames and run around the stadium distracting the audience. In your cute little asbestos suit, of course.
That's some plan.
All right, then. Let's go blow your little darlings up.
All right, folks. Hang on to your chili dogs, because it's time to start. The Corley Motor Smashatorium Amateur Driver Ultimate Destruction Maximum Carnage Marathon. Let's meet our crash cage gladiators. That mysterious-looking hooded figure wouldn't give us his real name. He prefers to be known as the Unknown Avenger. And that's just fine with us, isn't it, folks?
Now I'm just embarrassed for them. Who do they think they're fooling with those ludicrous disguises?
And next to him is another masked newcomer. Please give a big smashatorium salute to the Princess of Pileup, Doreen Schmorley.
All right, boys. Sick of them.
And finally, we have a last-minute addition to the lineup tonight. A deadly-looking team known as the Boom Boom Brothers.
Try and get away now, bicycle.
All right, now, are you ready to see some reckless driving? Are you ready to see some unnecessarily violent destruction? Then let the demolition derby begin.
Are you
Watch out for the Boom Boom Brothers, Mo.
Over here and nail me. These other cars forever.
Off the roof. Looks like these babies have a glass jaw. Finale.
Do it!
Now that's an explosion, ladies and gentlemen! Can't see any survivors! Wait, what's that? It's the unknown Avenger! That looks painful. We really should put him out right away, but what a show, huh?
Ben, quit clowning around and make a diversion.
I am a diversion.
No offense, but we need a bigger one. The bike is guarded.
Who cares about the bike?
Mo says it's important, so we're not leaving without it.
All right, I'll see what I can do, but I'm burning at both ends here.
Well, we should put him out, don't you think? Well, folks, it looks like the party's getting a little out of hand. The stadium seems to be catching fire, but let's all remain calm and... Yeah, you're right. The derby's over. Run for your life!
Finally. Now, squish that firefly while he's hot.
Look at him run.
Did you get him?
We finally got him, Bolas. That means Ripburger has to make us vice presidents now, like he promised, and give us 10,000 shares of stock each. Funny smell. What's that? The temperature light?
Well, on the bright side, I just made 20,000 shares of stock. Time to start the shareholders meeting.
Where's the hardtail?
All over the floor, Mr. Avenger.
What? What happened to your deep sentimental attachment to your father's vintage bike?
Ben, it's just a bike. I can put it back together in about a half an hour. That's assuming, of course, I can find that key.
What key are you talking about?
Key to my dad's safe. I remember he hid it somewhere on this bike, but I've looked everywhere and I can't find anything that even looks like a key.
What's in the safe that's so important?
My dad's will. I'm counting on him to tell the truth about me, finally.
Why did he keep you a secret all these years?
He didn't want people to find out about my mom.
What's so bad about Mrs. Corley?
She wasn't my mom.
But how are we going to get in the factory?
In the back of the factory, there's a secret entrance that leads straight into Dad's office. He used to sneak me in so I could help him with his bike designs.
When he got too old to do all the work himself?
Nah, this is back when I was 6.
How do I find the secret passage?
Well, it's tricky. You have to wait for all the utility meters to turn black. Then you kick the wall in just the right spot and you're in.
How was your flight?
Well, there were some explosions during takeoff, and I landed in a minefield. But other than that, it was fine.
I'm fine, by the way. Thanks for asking.
Great. Now help me find that key.
What are we in, anyway?
It's a C-330 Big Mouth Industrial Cargo Jumbo Transport we fixed up. We want to get it rolling so we can take it to biker rallies.
You're going to try to fly this thing?
Rolling, Ben. Rolling. This baby's flying days are over, just like mine.
Remember that time you tried to kill me?
Yeah, we really taught you a lesson. Get it?
How do I find the right spot to kick?
Dad just knew exactly where to kick it. But I remember that there was this big crack in the wall, and if I lined up that crack with my eye level and kicked the wall right in front of me, this weird portal would open up.
I'll see what I can do.
Right. Here, take the photos. I don't want them. Show them to someone important if you get a chance.
Very austere. No drawers. There's some sort of card. A tape. I sure hope that's Corley's will.
Was not only an inspirational leader, but also a great personal friend. His loss affects us all deeply. Malcolm and I spoke often of the future. We talked of a day when Corley Motors would move beyond its humble beginnings into a new vehicular age. And although his tragic death took him from us sooner than anyone expected, Malcolm Corley's dream remains. And I shall carry out that dream in his memory. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present to you the future of Corley Motors. The Corley Minivan.
Corley was right. I never dreamed it would actually come to minivans, though.